As some of you may be aware, there have been many false prophets looming about the last few weeks hoping to jump on a bandwagon that will allow them to shine, but with Satan, even though they think it's going to be with Jesus Christ on September 23rd. The main reason so many are doing this is because, as also prophesied, most don't read or even understand their Bibles today. Rampant disobedience has caused this kind of thing to be the norm in this generation. They have no vision. The people are going to perish because they don't keep the law. They don't understand. They don't even obey the God of the Bible they claim to worship. I mean, case in point, the Lord Jesus himself stated in Matthew 24, verse 36, "But of that day and hour knoweth no man, no, not the angels of heaven, but my Father only." Yet we now know there are millions of people out there claiming to be Christians who believe that Jesus Christ will return on September 23rd. How has this come to happen when the Bible was so clear about setting dates? Well, think about it. This is actually no different than asking a teenager to recite the U.S. Constitution or even a few lines from it. He can't do it because, unlike those of us from the late 1960s that had to pass a Constitution test even before entering high school, today's teenagers have never been shown the Constitution, let alone tested on it. Well, this is the exact same thing that has happened in the churches. For literally decades, we have seen churches change from places of worship, wherein the Bible was taught as well as the pastor could understand it, to becoming places to party, to meet friends, to listen to rock music, to enjoy preachertainers, and even get a tattoo or an ice cold beer. And I won't even get into what the Catholic Church has been doing for many decades with their bingo and Las Vegas nights. The Christians of today are for the most part exactly as Isaiah chapter 4 verse 1 predicted they would be. Isaiah stated that in that day, seven women shall take hold of one man, saying, "We will eat our own bread and wear our own apparel, only let us be called by thy name to take away our reproach." Now, I'm not going to define all those prophetic symbols in detail for you, because I have already defined every single prophetic symbol in Revelation on my website for those seekers serious about understanding prophecy. But if I was to put that passage in today's language, with each symbol defined, I would say this. In the last days, all the churches will claim Jesus Christ as Lord, but they will read the Bible the way they want to read it, and they will walk in the way that best pleases their flesh. But they're still going to demand we call them Christians to take away their shame. So what's going to happen on September 23rd? Well, you're going to see a lot of false prophets scrambling as quick as they can to delete their videos, change their websites, and turn off the comment sections on their YouTube channels so as to hide the fact they were wrong once again. In fact, I would think September 24th is going to see a lot more activity than September 23rd, and that all of them are going to be scurrying off to try to hide the fact that they've been exposed as false prophets, just as Jesus predicted in Matthew 24:11. And so I echo a statement Jesus made 2,000 years ago, that had those false prophets read their Bibles, they may have prevented losing their ministries on September 24th, or at least a good portion of them. Jesus said in Matthew 25, verse 13, "Watch, therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour wherein the Son of Man cometh." And when he says watch, he means to study your Bibles. For not only is the Word of God the place where everyone knows all those prophecies are listed, it is also the very same place all the prophetic symbols of those prophecies are defined. In other words, just as it was very easy for the Bereans of old to verify the truth they heard from the apostles, because Acts 17:11 said these were more noble than those in Thessalonica in that they received the word with all readiness of mind and searched the scriptures daily whether those things were so. They double-checked the stuff, right? Well, students of prophecy knew long before September 23rd came that each and every one of those preachers out there that said Jesus was returning on September 23rd were, in fact, false prophets. Obedience in the Lord allows for blessings that no man can comprehend. Proverbs 29:18 clearly says, "Where there is no vision, the people perish. But he that keepeth the law, happy is he." Thank you for watching. God bless.